Aloha! This is part 9 of my very exciting Let's Play of Fire Emblem Mancho no Nazo, aka Fire Emblem Mystery Crest, aka Fire Emblem 3, Book 2, on Nintendo Switch Online, in Japanese, Iron Man, 100% Houses Visited. We're back in the desert, and sweet Moses, are there a ton of mages this time. Just look at this place, it's lousy with mages. We're starting at the same place we did in FE1, so that isn't as cool. It doesn't feel any different. Thankfully though, Garnef isn't here, so we don't have to do any shenanigans where we lead him around in circles. There is a village way over in the northeast, and Marth needs to go there to recruit Minerva, who also comes with a Star Shard. He then needs to go all the way back to Seas. We definitely want to hurry here, since the traitor Astrum and his gang are hot on our tails and will show up after a certain amount of turns. Since the desert slows movement down so much, I'm going to try to use Fina to maximize Marth's long, lonely trek around the desert before the dastards show up in the south. Maybe I can use a Pegasus to lure those fiends in circles and buy myself more time, though. That seems like a decent plan that won't blow up in my face. The boss is a sage named Yodel. His portrait is pretty cool looking, too. I think it's a unique one, or at least one that we haven't seen yet. Anyway, we have to deal with him and steal his treasure, a guiding ring for Lind. There's also some treasure in the desert for Rickard to find while Julian grabs the treasure in the southeast. Let's go!
Thank you. We'll be right back.
So far, everything is going smoothly. Time for Ogma to absolutely ruin Yodel with a critical. Everything is looking great here. The traitor Astrum is going to be showing up soon, so I need to get Marth over to the castle and seize, and we'll be on our way. When the traitor Astrum and his gang appear, I decide to move Sita in to bait them into running around the desert after her. That seems like a brilliant plan. That should buy Marth enough time to get to seizing. One tiny problem. I forgot that Sita can't fly over the little island building in the southeast, and one of the snipers was actually pretty smart and moved to surround her. I can't seize with Marth yet, unfortunately, since he is barely a couple spaces away. Then I realize that Sita is completely and absolutely screwed. Maybe I can rescue her? Nope. Don't have Yumina with me. Uh-oh. The sniper bested me. My only hope at this point is that he misses his attack on Sita, because there is no way she can survive an attack from a silverbow sniper. Thankfully, she doesn't have any star shards on her, or I'd really have been screwed here. As it is, she's only carrying a javelin, I think, so let's see what happens. And there's no way she doesn't survive in this, and she is done for. She didn't stand a chance. Now Marth can seize. Nice job, buddy. Your inability to move more quickly got your betrothed killed. And that's chapter 9 down. One death, Sita. Poor Marth. Though Marisha and Katria are probably not too broken up about this turn of events. I hope you enjoyed, and we'll see you in chapter 10.